Good day to you. Today, we shall take up a discussion on boredom, getting bored. I hope you don't get bored with this session, but the background why I selected such a topic was very interesting. There was this person who walked in and was sitting and chatting with me and said, nowadays, you know, I'm getting very bored with dot, 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 dot. And he gave me a long explanation about what is boring him. Fine, I listened to him. Then he turned to me and said, what makes you bored? When do you get bored? Probably I had never asked this question to myself anytime. So I thought over and I said, I don't think I get bored. He laughed at me. How is that possible? I'm sure you get bored. Supposing you are stuck in a place which you don't like, or you have to wait for some thing and that thing keeps getting extended, or you're in a gathering where some discussion is going on which you just don't connect to, don't you get bored? I gave a thought to it again and I said, no. You know why? Because I observe people. So if I am stuck in a, let's say, a railway station or an airport, and I have to keep waiting. There are so many people around me whom I observe, and they keep my mind fully occupied. The same thing happens if there's a discussion going on around me where I can't get up and go away for whatever the reason, but I am just not connecting to the topic or the way they are discussing certain things. So you know what I do? I start observing and analyzing. Why does A say this? Why does B say that? Why is it that C doesn't seem to agree with both A and B? What must be going on in the mind of D, who's keeping quiet and not giving his opinion? And that keeps me fully occupied. I don't feel bored. Anyway, since most of us do get bored at times, let's understand what this concept of boredom is all about. I remember long back having read a small little book by a very eminent sports person who was also an excellent writer. He started off by saying, children started getting bored only after 1970. So I said, what is this? What's 1970 got to do with boredom of people? And then he explained, that was the year when in US we got cable TV. Before TV came in, people knew what to do. When TV and particularly multi-channel TV came in, they would just be switching channels, hoping that something interesting will come. And if there were 10 channels in those days, they would realize that none of those 10 occupy their mind. But the question that arises is, you sit down, switch on the TV, go to channel number 1, it is boring. You switch to channel number 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, all are boring. All you have to do is to press that red button, which shuts off the TV, get up and walk off. But you don't do it. And that is why this label of couch potato came in. People who would just sit on the couch and keep watching TV. And obviously, because of that, they started getting bored. Anyway, let us first understand what is boredom. Boredom is an emotion. Like so many other emotions you have this emotion called, boredom. It is when you feel disconnected with whatever is happening around you. You have nothing specific or nothing interesting to do, and you even start in an extreme boredom, you even start thinking that life is very dull. There's nothing interesting happening in my life. So interesting is on one side, boredom is on the other side. If you think that there is nothing interesting happening around you, you start feeling bored. But I keep asking this question to students whenever I'm addressing them. you know, almost every student says, there's some subject which I like, maybe one odd subject which I am fascinated with, I really enjoy. There are a couple of subjects which are okay. I like, I don't like, I manage. But there is at least one subject which I thoroughly dislike. I get bored when I'm asked to study that subject. Now, the question that I ask is, if I'm talking to, let's say, a group of students, I ask them, those of you who are interested in cricket, please raise your hands. So maybe 30, 40, 60, 70%, whatever it is, they raise their hands. Then I say, those who are not interested in cricket, raise your hand. The others raise their hand. Now I ask them, is cricket an interesting subject or an uninteresting subject? Half of you said it is interesting, half of you said it is uninteresting. But cricket is cricket. So what does it mean? There is no such thing as an interesting topic and an uninteresting topic. There are interested people and there are uninterested people. So the choice is yours, remember that. Since I mentioned that boredom is an emotion, you all know very well by now that emotions are a consequence of your thoughts. So you have a thought. This teacher is teaching something which I don't like. This guest has come into my house but is talking something which I'm just not connecting with. So when those thoughts come, you succumb to this emotion called boredom. And once you start feeling bored, you lose your motivation. You lose your enthusiasm. You don't even feel like doing something. It's like, you know, you walk into a neighbor's house and you see him watching TV or something and you say, sorry, I didn't want to disturb you. I think you're busy watching TV. The person may turn to you and say, no, come. I'm glad that you came. There's nothing interesting on TV. Oh, there's nothing interesting on TV. But you've been sitting there for the last 1 hour just changing channels. Did somebody force you to watch TV? No. So you see how what I'm leading on to is boredom is a consequence of your thoughts. And thoughts you can control. If you decide, like I told you in my own case, I'm sitting on this railway station, train is late, and nothing else to do. I don't even have a book to read. So what do? I don't have a smartphone in which I can put on Netflix and start watching it. So I watch people. And it's so fascinating when you watch people. There's so much to learn. So much of your curiosity is aroused. Whether you remember or not, when you were a child, you know, supposing you went to school by bus. At the end of the day, you're pretty tired. You've had so many periods, you've played games, you've done, studied, you've had a test, all that has been done. And you also have this heavy bag on your back. The bus drops you at the corner of your lane. Now, all you have to do is to walk down that lane. Maybe the 5th or 10th house is your house. Observe and see. How long does it take a kid to walk the distance of those 10 houses? Quite surprisingly, it may be 15 minutes. Why? Because when the bus leaves him and goes away, he doesn't turn around. He keeps staring at the bus. Maybe at the back of the bus, there is some friend of his who turns around and keeps waving at him. He keeps waving till the bus disappears. If by chance there's a traffic jam and the bus stops, he keeps staring this way, that way. What has caused the traffic jam? Why is the bus held up? Till it goes away. Then he turns around. He sees one auto rickshaw comes and stops. And the customer and the auto driver are having an argument. He goes closer and he starts looking at them. He starts observing, what are they arguing about? Who is winning the argument? Then when he turns around, he'll see a stray dog. And he wonders, hey, I didn't see this dog before. Where has he come from? and you start observing that dog, what he is doing, etc. If there is absolutely nothing to observe, he will see a tree and he will see some leaves hanging from a height. He'll start jumping up and down to see whether he can catch hold of that leaf and pluck it. He has no reason to pluck the leaf, but that's how he's keeping himself occupied. Similarly, the child may see a stone. He kicks that stone for no rhyme or reason. And the stone, instead of going in the direction of his house, it goes at 45 degrees angle. He walks up to that stone, again gives it a kick. And he continues doing that. And if you ask that child, it has been 15 minutes since you dropped, the bus dropped you, and you're still hanging around. Aren't you feeling bored? And that gives you a very clear idea. Ask yourself a simple thing. You may be, if you're a person who works outside the home in some office or wherever it is, your weekdays are pretty organized. You know you have to get up at this time, finish your breakfast by this time. Maybe there's a vehicle that picks you up, or you have to catch a bus, or you have to get your own vehicle ready, clean it, get it going, and then move to the office, do the work as prescribed by your seniors, finish the work and come back, etc. But what do you do on a Sunday? What do you do on a holiday? I know of people who Sunday after Sunday, they say, I'm getting bored. Now, don't you know that after every 6 days, a seventh day called Sunday comes? Don't you know that you have worked 5-6 days in the week and this day is off for you? Supposing somebody says, hey, if you're getting so bored sitting at home, why don't you go to office? Why should I go to office? Today's Sunday. I deserve my break. I deserve my holiday. Yes, you do. But you still haven't learned what to do with your holiday. And that is the reason why you are getting, bored. Anyway, I can go on and on rambling about these things. The idea is to understand and accept that people who are bored also become susceptible to things like depression, anxiety, anger, academic failure if they are students, or poor work performance if you're working in an organization, and most important, loneliness. If you cannot conquer your boredom, you will end up being lonely. So what is it that we can do about it? How is it that we can prevent boredom or remove boredom? Let's talk about adults. There are various ways by which you can prevent. Like I said, if the last 3 or 4 Sundays you have felt bored, it's high time you say, okay, next Sunday, I'm not going to allow myself to be bored. I'll find something to do which will keep my mind occupied. So what is it that we can do? So I compiled a few very basic, simple steps. You can create more of them by your own self. You can have many others, which are helpful to you. But this is just to set you on thinking that here are a few steps, or tips rather, by which you can keep away from boredom. So Anis has compiled it into a small PPT, and here you are. See, first thing I told you just now, people who are bored easily are susceptible. That's why I'm warning you. You are susceptible to depression, possibly, I'm saying. Not necessarily, but the warning is there. Anxiety about the future because you're sitting and doing nothing. Anger, irritability, short-temperedness. If you're a student, I told you, students who get bored don't perform well in academics. Similarly, if you're a working person, your work performance goes down if you are bored. And you are susceptible to loneliness because you are allowing boredom to take over with you. Loneliness, isolation, whatever you want to call it. Okay. Now let's move on to children. Children who say that they are bored, they may be simply looking for parental attention or acceptance. Be aware of this. They want some adults to engage with them. When all adults seem to be busy, they say, I'm getting bored. Now, here are the seven ways, as I said, among adults, how do you prevent boredom? First is, pick up a new hobby or restart an old one. It's not very difficult. Go back into your past and see, what is it that once upon a time you used to enjoy doing? Can I do that now? Or if there is something which I do enjoy doing even now, but I claim I'm not getting enough time. If you're not getting enough time, how are you getting bored? Think of the irony of that. Consider activities that you enjoyed in the past. Ask yourself why you stopped them. And inevitably, your answer to your own self will be, because I don't get time. On the one side, you are claiming that you don't get time. And on the other side, you are saying, I'm bored. Similarly, you can use technology to connect with others at an individual level. Not just these forwards and clips and Instagrams and all these things. They, in fact, make you more bored. But if you can get outside, go away from the four walls, from the concrete jungle, if there's a park near your house, if there are some open spaces, if you've got a vehicle, get onto the vehicle and just drive out of the city. Get out, observe nature, and your boredom automatically goes away. Nature has so much variety to offer. In the same manner, take on a challenge. That, okay, something which is difficult, which I never thought that I would be able to do. Come on, let me take up a challenge. The worst that will happen is I will fail. But I would have kept my mind occupied. And if I succeed, I'm very happy that I've succeeded. In the same manner, if you can't get out very frequently, have virtual tours. Look at what's happening outside your city, outside your country, outside your continent. There's so much variety to see, and that instigates you, that arises your curiosity. Next time you feel like getting out, you are a little more forward towards that. The same way, stick to a schedule. Most of the people who get bored easily, I've noticed, don't have a schedule. So they do something, they don't do something, and one fine moment they say, I don't have anything to do, and they say, I'm getting bored. But if you have a schedule, you say, okay, Sundays I'm off, I have no work. So what schedule can I make for Sunday so that my Sunday goes, you know, in a positive manner? And at the same point, moment, allot time to rest. Holidays are meant for rest after you have put in hard work. So try it out and see what you can do in all these, you know, areas. It takes a little bit of practice, persistence, etc. But you can succeed if you pick up. As I told you, these are just a few of the points which I have picked up. I'm sure you can think of so many others which you can do. A simple thing like playing with a child. It can be so interesting. One of my friend's father is going through very bad health conditions. If he has to walk 10 steps also, he says, no, I'm not confident. Hold my hand. I may fall down, etc. His extended family was going for a vacation outside the city and they invited him. First, he was very hesitant. He said, no, I'm not feeling well. If I fall sick there, what will happen? All that, he said, they're somehow convinced, and he went there. When he went there, his grandchildren started playing cricket. And you know what this gentleman did? He came and he started bowling. and he fell flat. He got up, told one of the boys, get me a chair. He got a chair, sat down in the chair and started bowling. You see how he got himself occupied? And those children were so thrilled that grandpa is playing with us and this and that. All your boredom gone in a jiffy. And in fact, his daughter was telling me the other day that his health is better. He's feeling more, you know, upright and more enthusiastic because of that. And in the same breath, he is keeping himself away from this epidemic of boredom, loneliness, pessimism. I don't have anything to do. I'm just waiting for my children to come back from school. I have retired. Now I have no other activity and nobody cares for me. My friends have all moved away. I'm not the type of person to keep making new friends. So I am getting bored. Along with this, one most important thing that I wanted to share with you is to develop some friends who are available to you 24/7 into 365 into as many years as you are going to live. Can you get such a friend? You'll laugh at me. How can you predict? Okay, today somebody may be a close friend. Tomorrow he may get busy or he may not like me or he may die or something like that can happen. What's the guarantee? I'll give you that guarantee. I'm not talking about human beings as friends. I'm talking about books. In today's era, where many, many, many people have given up the habit of reading, I meet adults who say, as a child, I used to be an avid reader. I used to love reading, right from comics to biographies to novels to this and that. Slowly, I came to higher classes. I got busy. Parents said, don't waste your time reading storybooks. Come on, read only your textbooks. And from there, the downfall started and my reading habit came down. Today, you know what? I do like to read. I pick up a book and start reading. In 2 pages, I start feeling drowsy. I get sleepy. So I get up, close the book and go off. Or sit and watch Netflix. 1.5 hour movie on Netflix, I don't get bored. To read 10 pages of a book in 10 minutes, I say that I get bored. Now, boredom is inside you. The same way as I told you, there is no such thing as interesting topics and uninteresting topics. In the same breath, let me tell you, boredom is within you. And like I mentioned, today's children are getting more and more and more bored. And parents are getting exasperated. Don't come and bug me every now and then. Go and do something. Bye, you tell you. Now, if a parent can handle a child properly, see how you can get. This is one of the thoughts that came to our mind as we were discussing. So 2 of my colleagues decided, okay, we'll do a little skit and show the viewers of today how a parent can handle a child's boredom. Here you are.
Mama, please give me your phone. I want to play in your phone.
I have a work call to receive. Please go play.
Mama, please. I'm good. Please.
Can you play with this toys for now?
I don't want
to. Achha. Can you go to the blackboard and write something?
I don't want to. Please. Just give me your phone. I want to play.
I cannot.
Mama, please. If you are not giving your phone, please order pizza.
Done. You want pizza? Okay.
Yay, Mama is making pizza.
I am not making pizza. We are making it together.
But how?
Let's do one thing. Since I told you that I have a work call, I will complete it. Till then, can you go to the refrigerator over there and see what toppings you want? Check whether there are mushrooms, bell peppers, cheese and other things. Okay.
Getting pizza.
Now I have found out that Kanaka is interested in making pizza with me. Just like that, I will find out many other ways where she can involve herself, reduce her boredom and her screen time as well.
Yes, all of us who are in some way or the other connected with children, not necessarily only parents, all of us who are in some way connected with children have to acknowledge and accept that children's attention span has gone down and they start getting bored very easily, and then they throw tantrums and the adults give in and say, okay, stupid girl, go ahead and take it, order your pizza or whatever it is. It is we who are responsible for such a situation. If I make up my mind that I will do something to actually take away the boredom of my child, you saw when Sophia realized that Kanaka is not willing to play with her toy, not willing to write on the blackboard, not willing to go to the next door neighbor and play with her. What do I do? If you have that little time and inclination, she said, go to the fridge, open, take out the things which are useful for pizza. Now, what are you doing by that? You are, you know, increasing the curiosity of the child. You are making the child take decisions. Do I want tomato? Do I want onion? Do I get one onion or do I get two onions? Which would taste better? What would I like? Recall last time when we had ordered pizza, they had a lot of cheese in it. So does cheese make the pizza more tasty? So should I pull out some cheese and keep it on the table so that mama can add the cheese also to my pizza? This is how the whole thing goes. And once a child is away from the screen and starts spending time in doing constructive things which stimulate all her senses, she gets to open the fridge and see on every shelf what is there. She hears particular sounds. She smells something. She takes out something and tastes it. So each of her senses is getting stimulated. And this whole process of taking decisions, fixing up things, and finally putting it to mama to make it into a pizza is a life skill. This is how the child is engaging herself to do meaningful things. And in the process, the child doesn't feel bored. The child finds other ways from time to time to keep herself occupied, not only with pizza, not only with cooking, not only with something else, inevitably. So if we can develop that curiosity in ourselves, that let me explore the world around me. If I can just sit in the balcony and watch people going past and observe who is going fast, who's going slow, who's talking to somebody, who's shouting at somebody, there's so much to learn. And you don't feel bored because you feel that there's something to occupy your mind. Anytime, even if there's a so-called boring person who comes to you and starts going on jabber, 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 try to read between the lines. What makes him talk so much? What is making him so restless that he wants to prove something to me and that's why he's going on talking? That type of curious mind will enable you to understand, accept, and be with things, you know, which will ensure that you will not feel that boredom, which is such a debilitating emotion, it can really kill you. So that is what my message to you today is. Now I take my 1 minute break and Sonal is here to update you quickly on what is happening and I will be back.
Good afternoon, viewers. Lovely to see you all on Saturday after Saturday. And you just saw the information that we wanted to share with you next Saturday,
the 29th of June, we will not have FB talk. Curious minds? Yeah? To tell you why, I will just explain you what are we going to do that day. That's why we don't have an FB talk. There are two things happening. One is there is a workshop on counseling skills at IIT Queen's Road. You all, whoever has been associated with Banjara will know what is where is IIT, and the workshop is happening there in the morning hours. So whoever is willing to join, whom you think want to know okay, what is counseling skills, you can pass this information to them. Yeah. And they can call up office and Anisa or Jennifer or Banu will help them to get registered for this. Apart from that, in the afternoon from 2:30 to 5:30, we are inaugurating our new batch for Diploma in Counseling Skills. That is the 26th batch. Isn't it exciting to know that? The 26th batch of DCS is starting and the seats are getting filled up. Whoever you think that, you know, want to know or you want them to come and join the inaugural class and then take a decision, Anise will help you out through the process. Just get in touch with her and she will help you out. As always, she does, right? So Diploma Skills in Counseling Skills is happening. Workshop in Counseling Skills is happening next week. No FB talk. And furthermore, as and when whatever is going to come up, yeah, Anise has just put up the updates, what's happening at Banjara. CCAD, Certificate in Child and Adolescent Development. I think last few seats are left. If anybody is interested in knowing children or want to work in the field of children or is just generally concerned about well-being of children's mental health, well-being, anything, they can think of joining this course. I think by Monday or next week, we will stop the admissions for that. Then, as I told, workshop on counseling skills is happening on 29 June from 10 to 1 at IIT Queen's Road. And exclusive intense workshop on mindfulness. This is coming up because one mindfulness workshop happened last month and people have really enjoyed it. They said we just understood that, you know, mindfulness is just being in the present, but they understand much more beyond what mindfulness is. Not only about now and today. What is mindfulness all about? That curiosity you need to keep, and for that you can come and join the session. You will really enjoy because it's going to be taken exclusively by Dr. Ali. Yeah. So good afternoon everyone once again. And start posting your questions or your sharings and, you know, make this session more lively for yourself. Don't get bored, right?
Yes, I'm back. And as the slide showed you just now, next Saturday we will be taking a break because we have two things lined up on that day. The counseling workshop for those who are not counselors and who want to learn what is counseling. And of course, followed by the inauguration of our 26th batch of DCS. Okay, so coming back to the topic of today, Mr. Kumar Swami says, Namaste Ali and team Banjara. Happy to join. Thanks for arranging talks every Saturday. Our pleasure, sir. Except next Saturday, we will be back again, hopefully on every possible Saturday, unless there's something very, very important. Okay, Surekha says, the moment you accept responsibility for everything in your life is the moment you gain the power to change anything in your life. Exactly, Surekha, you have hit the nail on the head that you need to take responsibility. So even if I am sitting in the airport or at the railway station or in a doctor's clinic with nothing to do and waiting, I take responsibility. I decided to go to this busy doctor. I decided to catch a flight, which I know the flight can possibly be late. Why is it that I didn't value my time and I didn't prepare myself and now I'm complaining that I'm getting bored? That should be the attitude, right? Okay. Surekha also says, boredom can spur us to set goals for ourselves. It should spur us, Surekha, but many of us don't. We just keep complaining, I'm getting bored. Not just a child like Kanaka's role play, but even adults say that. What is this? This doctor's taking so much time. I'm getting bored and all that. So if we can convert that to say boredom should spur us to set goals for ourselves. And having something to work towards can give us a sense of purpose and direction, thus reducing boredom. I have a friend who works for a very, very important and a big company, but unfortunately he's got a boss who calls a meeting and then just rambles on away from the topic of the meeting. Something 10 years back, I did this or that is happening, or how the weather is very bad or the traffic is bad and all that. He says, I take a small booklet and pen and I start jotting down some thoughts. Maybe next quarter I should do something about my sales targets. I think I should spend a little more time with my son playing cricket with him. So I keep on jotting down those points. The moment boss comes to the point of discussion of the meeting, I just close this and I start participating. So I don't know whether the boss has spent 2 minutes or 12 minutes, but I have not felt bored because I kept myself occupied. Karthik says, boredom can lead to addiction to certain things, making the person introvert. Yes, Karthik, not only making the person introvert, because I said so, that isolation, loneliness and all that, but also what you rightly pointed out, addiction. There are people who have to wait long periods of time for something and they start smoking a cigarette. And before you know it, they take out a second cigarette and a third cigarette. So where are they headed? They are headed towards addiction for smoking. Anything like that. There are people who pull out the mobile and start watching things which they should not be watching. But that's the only thing that keeps them occupied. Otherwise, they say, I get bored. So they go deeper and deeper and deeper. And there are enough and more people on the social media who take advantage of you if you start moving towards addiction. Right. Surekha also says, digital distraction reduces. No, what happened? Digital distraction reduces boredom, but then the less people experience boredom, the less equipped their brains are to deal with it. Agreed. But why do we need to go through some negative experiences to deal with it? Why do I have to injure myself 10 times to be able to deal with injuries? If I take a positive step, it is the mindset which is important. Whether it is boredom, whether it is physical pain, whether it is mental pain, whether it is loneliness, it is the mind that controls you. And if you train your mind is trainable. A lot of research recently has gone on in neurology to show that the mind is not a fixed organ, the brain. It can be reprogrammed from time to time. And that is what we need to do, right? Surekha has given a very good example. My grandmother refused to stop playing the game Snakes and Ladders after losing 6 times in a row. And when I suggested that she could go to bed, you know what she said? I am not going to sleep, Amma. It's not over till I win. With an attitude like that, she will surely be able to handle boredom whenever it hits her. Exactly. Even a small child can be taught, like you saw in the skit where the mother says, come on, let's make a pizza. Or like Surekha told the child that, okay, what is happening? I want to win and then only it will be over. That determination, that enthusiasm will ensure that as the child grows up, the child will be able to handle any of these small, small hurdles and setbacks and all these things and not get bored. Okay, now the point here that I'm raising is that for many people, boredom may also be an ideal time to spark some creativity and innovation. If you realize tomorrow that I am getting bored, I have nothing to do. I also gave you the example of this friend of mine who starts using his creative juices when he's sitting in a boring meeting, which I've got nothing to do with him. Probably the boss is just, going on bragging about what he did so many years back. There are times, for example, he has told me that I sit and write notes to my children. My daughter is very small. She can barely read, he told me. But I sit there and write that I am in office, but I'm remembering you. I was thinking that if I am with you, I can play this game. He takes it back. He takes one note to the son. The son can read. He's happy. See, even in office, I remember you better. And the boy is happy. But his daughter cannot read. So you know what he does? He reads it out to her. This is what I wrote in office, only for you. And gives that note. And he has been pleasantly surprised that she has been very carefully filing each one of those notes in a plastic folder. That much she values. It is because it is the father's sentiment which is reaching out to her. Okay. Yes. Archana says, I connect with today's topic. The moment my son gets into the car, he starts complaining that he is bored. When I offer him to count the number of cars, observe the different kinds of people traveling on the road, he denies it. A half-hour journey becomes a difficult thing for him. I try to carry books to read along with him. He looks forward to entertainment every moment. Attention span has become very less these days. And attention span, having become less and less, is also confining itself to the 6 inches of the mobile phone. Now, when the car is moving on the road, be it in the city or be it in the countryside, you know and I know how much there is to observe. How many new things. And you don't have to have a long attention span. You watch something by the time the car has moved on. Then watch something else. Look at the right. Look at the left. Go ahead and do that. But why is it that children are not even willing to, look around and see and talk about it? Number one, because parents don't do it. If the parents develop that habit with the child, come on, we are going out. Today we are going to Jayanagar, or today we are going outside the city to a farmhouse. And on the way, we are likely to see some interesting things. And they start talking about it. The child also learns to follow what the elders or the parents are doing. Surekha says, boredom can provoke us to take risks, because the person who risks nothing is nothing, does nothing, and becomes nothing. Exactly. If you allow boredom to overwhelm you, then you say, life is so boring, I've got nothing interesting to do, there's nothing which helps me in the poor me, miserable me, and all these things. Yes. Yeah, we already seen this. So, boredom can provoke us to take less. Okay. Madhuri says, boredom, I don't want in my house. First thing, I never told I am bored. I always say 24 hours is less for me, even till day. So, my children never say I am bored. If they are bored, immediately I show 100 ways to kill boredom. COVID also never affected, even that time, not a single day was boring. Hats off to you, Madhu. If you could have done that to your family and ensured that even a horrible thing like COVID, where everybody was locked in within the four walls of their house, even there, if you could find, as you have said, that the moment that happens, I show 100 ways to kill boredom. Amazing. If you can't think of 100 ways, think of 10 ways, 5 ways, 3 ways. You say 1, 2, 3. These are the 3 options I'm giving you. Tell me which one you like and I'll do it with you. We'll do it together. And that's what stimulates people. You show your interest and other people also get interested. And explore, talk about it, explain why this is important, what they have done earlier, what they're likely to do. Now, that's how it goes. Yes. Mr. Kumar Swami also says, Ali, can you please share light on how to identify the symptoms in children who are really on the threshold of going deep down the addiction? And it's difficult to bring him back to normalcy. As a layperson, how can we really study symptoms? Very simple and very easy. Boredom is one of them. If a child says, I'm bored. If a child says, nobody plays with me, I am lonely. If a child says, I am no good because I don't get good marks, my teacher always scolds me because I get less marks than my friends. Now, these are indications that the child will start looking for some ways and means to fill that up. And what is the easiest way? Addiction. Among addiction, at least for the smaller children, the most convenient addiction is technology. It is free, it is available. Everybody, most of the children have their own mobiles. If they don't have, they can pick up their parents' mobile and they start playing games. World Health Organization has told us many years back that addiction to technology-related games is a mental disorder. But do we heed it? No. As small children, they are encouraged to play games so that they don't disturb the adults. That is the fatal mistake that we make. And the moment you find that the child is repeatedly doing the same activity, be it mobile, be it anything else, he's getting addicted to it, start offering him or her alternatives, which can be equally interesting, equally enjoyable, but they give a variety. And as long as there's variety in the child's life, he will not get addicted to anything specific. Roshan says, parents' responsibility to see that a child is never bored. Yes, I agree. If he is occupied all the time, the same thing will be carried into adulthood, obviously. To keep yourself occupied and not think negatively, club is the best place where one can socialize and choose the activity. Exactly. You find your own way. Everybody has their own ways and means, but it should not be within the confines of the 15 inches of your laptop or 6 inches of your mobile. There is a big world outside the screens. You observe, you experience, and you enjoy. And it slowly filters down to the children in the house. They also start observing, they also start experiencing, and they also start enjoying. So make a point after today's session to just jot down a few activities which could remove your boredom, boredom of your family members, boredom of children around you, and start experimenting with it. Even if there is no boredom, prevention is better than cure, isn't it? So start now and say, I'm going to make a list of all possible activities, games, something or the other, something to read, something to, you know, perform, something else. Keep making those. And depending on the situation, depending on the availability of various things, you can start moving into that and doing those activities. And thereby, you can keep away from this concept of boredom and you can keep your loved ones away from it. Do work on it. As I said, we are not meeting next Saturday, but the Saturday after that, I will be back. And Anis is showing you the topic, very, very firebrand topic, I would say, changing face of marriage. How marriage has evolved within each generation and particularly the current generation. So I've collected a lot of data, I'll continue to collect, and I welcome any inputs from you. Either give me a call and tell me, or send me an email or a message or whatever it is. I will incorporate that into the notes which I am already in the process of making and completing. And we shall hopefully on the 6th of July, Saturday, from 2 to 3 p.m., we'll have a nice discussion on this changing phase of marriage. Until then, have a nice time, take care of yourself, and bye-bye.
Please give me your phone. I want to play in your phone.
I have a work call to receive. Please go play.
Mama, please. I'm good, please.
Can you play with this toys for now?
I don't want to.
Acha. Can you go to the blackboard and write something?
I don't want to. Please, just give me your phone. I want to play.
I cannot.
Mama, please. If you are not giving your phone, please order pizza. Order pizza.
Done. You want pizza? Okay.
Yay, Mama is making pizza.
I am not making pizza. We are making it together.
But how?
Let's do one thing. Since I told you that I have a work call, I will complete it. Till then, can you go to the refrigerator over there and see what toppings you want? Check whether there are mushrooms, bell peppers, cheese and other things. Okay.
Getting pizza.
Now I have found out that Kanaka is interested in making pizza with me. Just like that, I will find out many other ways where she can involve herself, reduce her boredom and her screen time as well.